So it's been a couple weeks, but I'm just about ready to delve into Fallout London for real. But before I do that, I'd like to share how I decided to install it. Most of the instructions are good, but the installer in the final step destroys Fallout 4 and makes it irreversible. What I did instead was redirect Fallout 4 to read the Fallout London GOG installation directly. There's no 30GB zip files, no excessive rewriting or overwriting, and most importantly, the first patch for Fallout London just dropped, and I don't need to run the patch installer. Fallout 4 just reads the GOG folder directly. I'll explain more on the end, but just in case, I'd like to go over the full installation process. Feel free to skip to the end if you only need to know the main change. First off, you need to obtain and install the three major parts: Mod Organizer 2, Fallout London, and the second newest version of Fallout 4. Mod Organizer 2 is on GitHub, and when setting it up, make sure you have profile-specific .ini files and save files enabled. Afterwards, open the folder to where you installed MO2 and leave the window open at the mods folder. This is where Mod Organizer 2 actually installs mods, and you'll need this window later. To install Fallout London, simply press install and wait for it to finish. Don't press play when it's done, because this starts the installer that we're trying to avoid. It even warns you that this will be a destructive installation. For Fallout 4, if you own the game on GOG, you will already download the second newest version of the game. If you just installed it, start the game at least once to set your profile settings, then you can skip the rest of this section. Most of you, however, would be on Steam. First, install the game anyway and start it once to set your profile settings. From here, you can use an automated downgraded program they made, but if you're uncomfortable with using it to log into Steam, you can do it manually in the developer console. 14 commands, 14 chunks. This seems to be a stumbling point for some people, so instead of repeating the manual instructions, I'd like to point out some traps. First, you should make sure auto-updates are disabled in Steam. Second, go to where Fallout 4 was installed, and go up a few levels. Look for an app manifest file with this ID number and set it to read only. This permanently disables updates. Also, make a backup of this in case you lose it, because this is Steam's install registration file and was the only thing we wanted. Then, go back into the Fallout 4 folder and delete everything, or move everything out. We only wanted the game to be registered in Steam and ran once, because when we downgrade, we're actually downloading the whole game again, all 30GB. After you've downloaded everything, it will all be in a temporary folder. Merge all of these chunks together and move this into the Fallout 4 folder. Don't overwrite the existing installation. I say again, delete it first, then copy or move the old files. We don't want any newer files to cause interference, like the Creation Club files from the latest update. We want this clean. Before moving on, be sure to keep this window open for later. Now, we can install Fallout London, or rather, connect Fallout London into Fallout 4. Open the folder for where GOG Galaxy installed it. We're going to take two sets of files out of this, and then create the shortcut. First, take the .ini files inside the config folder and go to the profile folder in Mod Organizer 2. These are the profile-specific .ini files, so replace them with what you took. Next, take the F4SC files and copy-paste them into the Fallout 4 folder. The script extender is the only mod you ever need to install into Fallout 4, since every other mod usually goes into the data folder. Finally, here is the key link-up process and how my installation method differs. Going back to the Mod Organizer 2 mods folder, I'll explain what this is. Mod Organizer 2 works by never actually installing mods into Fallout 4, and instead merges the folders together when you start the game. Aside from installing the script extender, which is necessary because it's above the data folder, this makes Fallout 4 completely isolated in vanilla. If you run Fallout 4 via Steam without Mod Organizer 2 running first, you'll have no mods at all. This folder is where your installed mods actually go with this system, and you can insert one manually. At this point, you can create a folder here and move the Fallout London data folder in here. You can do that if you want, but it makes patching complicated. Instead, we'll take an extra step and create a shortcut here that points to the data folder instead. To do this, open Windows Command Prompt. Then type the following command: makelink or mklink, then /j for junction. Then, in quotes, the path to MO2's mod folder, then a slash and the folder name of the shortcut. There shouldn't be a folder with that name here. Then, in quotes, the path to the data folder, not the GOG install folder, but the data folder inside for Fallout London. When it's done, it will look like a shortcut, but if you open it, the path acts like a real folder with that name instead of the name data. But it's actually the GOG Galaxy folder, so GOG Galaxy can still patch it at the same time. Now, you can start up Mod Organizer 2 and this shortcut will appear as an installed mod. Enable it, run the game with F4SC, and you're in. Fallout 4 is in an isolated vanilla state. Fallout London never hard overwrites the game, and it also stays where GOG Galaxy can see it, so it can update flawlessly without using any extra future patch installers. Now, I'm ready to play and everything is good to go.
We won't go quietly.
Like, subscribe, go see my Patreon, stay safe, and remember, mind the gap.